walnut tree, Coccus nucifera, is a member of the palm tree family and the only living species of the genus Coccus. The term coconut can refer to the whole coconut palm, the seed or the fruit, which botanically is a drupe, not a nut. The name comes from the old Portuguese word coco, meaning head or skull, after the three indentations of the coconut shell that resemble facial features. They are umbiquitous in coastal tropical regions and are a cultural icon of the tropics. What makes the coconut so versatile and unique among the fruits and vegetables? Its food and drink in a shell, and almost every part of the tree is utilized. The coconut is a tree of life. There is no part of it that is not useful for human beings. The trunk makes for building material, and the long pinnate leaves can be fashioned into everything from thatched roofs to baskets. The sap from the floral stalks is sweet enough to be turned into palm jaggery or boiled down into coconut honey, and has enough yeast to turn naturally ferment itself into intoxicating toddy. Both the flowers and the apical buds are edible. The almost kilogram and a half a heavy fruit with fibrous husk that is used to make coir, a woody shell that serves as a serving cup of ladle, an astonishingly flavorful white flesh that is 35% fat, and let's not forget, a delicious summer drink that can be had straight from the fruit. It is food and drink in a shell. It is to use the Sanskrit compound known the kalpavriksha. The history of this amazing tree is as fascinating as it's eye-pleasing. Sinuous, shape-hugging coastlines around the world. The fruit is designed to keep the baby coconut inside nourished for almost a full year. This means that a mature coconut can simply fall into the sea and travel thousands of kilometers and start growing on a beach somewhere else. This is how the tree is said to have spread from its ancestral home in Southeast Asia to almost every tropical coastline in the world. Since plants rarely leave fossils, we turn to linguistics to trace its migratory path. The flesh of a mature coconut is 45% water, 35% fat, most of it saturated fat, which makes it like animal fat, 10% carbohydrates, and 5% protein. The uniquely nutty, sweet, and aromatic flavor profile of the flesh comes from the molecules that are derivatives of saturated fatty acids like lactones. The fresh flesh can be grated into a paste and used as a thickening agent that can also lend a rich flavor of many dishes from South India. The paste is essentially cell debris mixed with coconut fat, droplets, and water. The best way to extend its shelf life is to freeze the grated coconut paste as ice cubes. In fact, you can go one step further and blend spices with the coconut and freeze that as a quick flavor bomb which can be added to dishes. The fats in the coconut dissolve a lot of spice flavor molecules, one of the reasons so many dishes from the south feature coconut. Dried or desiccated coconut has a longer shelf life because of lower moisture levels, but it will also turn rancid after a few days at room temperature because unrefined coconut fat will break down into free fatty acids. Dried coconut can be used to add a delicious nutty flavor to spice mixes like goda masala and dishes like bisibele bhat. You can also add a tiny bit of instant yeast to fresh coconut water with some added sugar to help the yeast get going, and let it ferment for a couple of days to make a deliciously fizzy and mildly alcoholic beverage. Using coconut palm jaggery or sugar instead of regular sugar adds slightly more depth of flavor to desserts and is less cloyingly sweet than cane sugar. Coconut oil is commonly used in cooking, especially for frying. It can also be used in liquid form as other vegetable oils or in some solid form similar to butter or lard. Coir, the fiber from the husk of the coconut, is used in ropes, mats, tow mats, brushes and sacks, as cockling of boats, and as stuffing fiber for mattresses. It is used in horticulture in potting compost, especially in orchid mix. The coir is used to make brooms in Cambodia. The stiff midribs of coconut leaves are used for making brooms in India, Indonesia, Malaysia, the Maldives, and Philippines. The green of the leaves is stripped away, leaving the veins, which are tied together to form a broom or brush. A long handle made from some other wood may be inserted into the base of the bundle and used as a two-handed broom. The leaves also provide material for baskets that can draw well water and for roofing thatch. They can be woven into mats, cooking skewers and kindling arrows as well. Leaves are also woven into small pouches that are filled with rice and cooked to make poso and ketupat. In India, the coconut tree Coccus nucifera has been considered from time immemorial as Kalpa Vriksha, literally meaning a tree of heaven and a tree that bestows all boons. The tree remains productive even at the age of 80 to 120 years and produces good quality copra, oil and other products.